But I didn't mention when I was throwing that I was throwing it upside down. The part that touches the bat is the part that touches the pot. And so this is the thickness I told you about, which is pretty heavy and a lot of clay to put on your pot. So I've got this centered. This is the part, so it's standing right side up. This is the part that's going to go on the pot, and I'm just going to trim it. And trim the outside. I'm going to get rid of quite a bit of that clay there. Again, I don't worry too much about how much art weighs. I think asking how much it weighs is very personal. Don't worry about it. Like, you have to have enough clay here to have a pedestal to hook onto your bowl. It has to all work. I'm gonna redefine with one of my favorite tools, with the spoon. And sponge that out. Now I'm gonna score this and attach it to the bowl in a minute. And it's always important, a lot of times I don't always score. If clay has the same moisture content, a little bit of what I call wet and wiggle, just adding some slip between, and you make the slip just by rubbing the clay and it makes the slip. But if you're attaching two pieces of clay that aren't the same moisture content, you're gonna have different shrinkage, and it's very important to score them and add your slip. So what I'm gonna do with this is I like to score using the wheel. The wheel is just a tool. Think about it as just another way of making your pots. It does more than just spin pots. It makes a good way of scoring your pots. So there's scored using the wheel, and I'll add some water to that, and we'll attach it to its bowl in just a bit.